French Polynesia's capital is usually a bustling town centre. These days, Papeete is empty. The country's schools, shops and main resorts and hotels have been closed for over a month now, a necessary measure to stop the spread of the COVID-19 virus. Their nationwide curfew ended this week as the number of new cases decreases daily. And over half of the total recorded cases have recovered.
One of the important things that we have to remember is that early contact tracing is really important. That's what helps us contain the epidemic. The other thing as well is in terms of the measures that have been put in terms of restriction.
Here at Tahiti's crisis unit, health authorities are working on a plan to rid the territory of the virus.
The strategy is to try and do an aggressive tracing of all the contact cases. So all the contact cases are then contacted, tested, observed, and put in quarantine. What will happen if we get a new wave of the epidemic? So we just got to keep trying and work on these things.
French Polynesia is one of only five Pacific countries whose labs have the resources to test for the virus, a tool that may come in handy once the country opens its borders again.
We also are dealing today with some kind of test that we would like to prepare for the future tourists that will come to French Polynesia. And, well, it's going to take us some weeks before we get at this level.
While French Polynesian citizens who are stuck in France start to make their way home, Papeete is also still receiving medical supplies from France every 10 days. But measures have been put in place by the government to make sure the island nation is kept contained.
We stopped all the flights between French Polynesia and all our markets outside, although we still have planes going to Paris because we have the continuity of the flights for the people having health problems that needs them to go to Paris in the hospitals and come back here.
Ce qui concerne la mortalité hospitalière, nous déplorons 13,236 décès.
France has the fourth highest amount of COVID-19 cases behind the US, Spain and Italy. And now they have more than 300 deaths a day. Though closing its borders is necessary, the economic impacts on local business and tourism is being felt.
First of all, on the jobs, because we have to maintain the jobs we have in the hotels, in the restaurants, and all the other small companies where we have here. It's going to be very difficult in time, but we have to start somewhere.